everyone. We're so happy that you could join us again for Marked by Prayer. It's our online daily devotion where we have the opportunity to get together, have a little conversation, and to most importantly, get into God's Word. My name is Raina Wright, and this is my friend, Luann Hunter, and we're just going to dive right in. This week, we are in a great series called Resurrection Power, and if you've been with us, you'll know we've touched on different things that the resurrection power does for us as believers. We talked about how it reverses the order of things, how the resurrection power reinforces our strength. It restores our hope and it releases our fears, which is where we're going to land today.
Yeah, I think for most of us, we all have fears in our life. You know, you can see those things online of the top fears. And we talked about, you know, fear of spiders or a fear of public speaking.
Yes.
But I think one of the top fears that most people have is a fear of death.
Yeah.
And so today in our Resurrection Power series, we're kind of talking about that, you know, Christ in us, that power that is at work within us, it frees us from fear. It releases our fears, that we don't have to be afraid. If God, through Christ, was able to conquer death, then really we don't have anything to be afraid of.
Exactly. We can put all of our faith in the power that raised Jesus from the dead. That same power is at work in us, no matter what we're afraid of. If we've done it on our own accord, a mess of our own making is what we've referred to it as. If something has been done to us or around us or whatever the situation may be, we don't need to be afraid because it's not too big for our God.
No, and you know, during this time of COVID, and I know that there is so much uncertainty right now, you know, will I have a job in, you know, the next few months? How am I going to pay my bills? You know, am I ever going to be able to be together with my friends or to be able to travel? Or, you know, what does this mean? And there's a lot of anxiety and fear that kind of brings up in people. And so I think today, as we're in this series on resurrection powers, is that we need to be reminded that, you know, Christ in us and the power that rose Jesus from the dead, that dunamis power, that dynamite power, is at work within us. And so our scripture passage today, I want to read that. It comes from Romans 8, verse 31, and then verses 38 and 39. And it says, "What then shall we say in response to these things? If God is for us, if God is for us, who can be against us? For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord." You know, as we're reading that, Raina, I think about that verse that says, perfect love drives out fear. Mm-hmm. And the love that God has for us, it is perfect in every possible way. And so, I don't know, I am encouraged by this passage.
Absolutely.
That I don't have to be afraid.
Right, absolutely. And it covers it all. I love how it just covers all the bases. Nothing that's happened in the past, nothing that's going to happen in the future, nothing that we can see that's unseen. Everything is under the umbrella of God is for us. And then also in this chapter, we always laugh about one more verse.
Right.
But also in the same chapter, it says that all of these things, God will use them for our good. And so that's in here too. I encourage you to go and look in Romans 8 and read through it, because it is a power-packed chapter, just full of hope about this resurrection power that we have access to, that we get to tap into.
Yeah, and so today, if you're watching, and you know, whether the thing that you're afraid of, that you're fearful of, is of your own doing, as we talked about yesterday, if it's something that you have done and perhaps you feel like you deserve it, or even if it's just things that are outside of your control, we want us to walk in the peace and the confidence that comes to knowing that Christ in us, that resurrection power, lives in us. And so, Raina, if you'll pray for us today to be able to walk in that confidence.
Sure, absolutely. And Father God, we come to you, Lord, and we just thank you that you are perfect love. As Luann said, Lord, perfect love drives out fear. And we thank you that you have the power to release us from our fears and that you want to release us from our fears, Lord, that you don't want us to be people of fear, but you want us to be people of faith. Faith that you have our best in mind, that you are working all things for our good, Lord. And I just pray that even more today than ever before, you would open our eyes, God, make us aware of this rich inheritance that we are heirs to, Lord, that we indeed are your daughters and your sons, and we have every right and every access to call on you in our time of need. And Father, you are faithful to deliver us over and over again. Father, we thank you for this time. We thank you for Marked by Prayer and the chance to come together and to proclaim the gospel and your good news and resurrection power. We love you so much, and we pray these things in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Thanks for joining us. Don't forget, tomorrow is Sunday services. We'd love for you to join us online for our next installment of our prayer series with Pastor Bobby. And we look forward to seeing you on Monday morning. Have a great weekend.